Valmiki, he chanted his mantra 60,000 years. down passing water without moving. They are eating or sleeping. All these bones were covered by it. Even my hands, he was covered by an angel, white and unaccustomed. Then after 60,000 years, all the nouns are appeared at a time, bombing me by nouns. By chanting the name of Brahma backwards, after 60,000 years, he had the asana of the Sarupa Brahma, the pastimes of Brahma. And what he saw in his Bhaktisamani, he wrote, that is called Ramayana. So we think I took the initiation 2 weeks ago, and still not became perfect. What's happening? And for not so easy, you know. For some of you, Sandra Ramani, you got bhajan. And after so many, many years, he got to a soul. Therefore, mantra is everything inside, mantra is everything is there. Master Gauri Maharaj used to say, after initiation, don't ask me words of Radha Krishna. I already give you Radha Krishna in the form of Mahamantra, in the form of Gurudeva Mantra, Gauranga Mantra, Radha Krishna. Bhagavan is there. Only we have to chant Guru. One time I asked, would you pass Guru Maharaj? Maharaj, what should we think of when we chant the God? And he said, I asked that same question to my Guru, the Guru of Vishnu, what to do in this one. And my Guru said, what? Nothing! Just chant the mantra. Everything is in the mantra. When you chant the mantra purely, then Bhagavan reveals himself. It's a number of chantaks, even on the spiritual domain of the Sanaman, seen in your system, but they can have a rock. Everything begins with the name. The Rupa Goswami says, Nama Rupa Chalatari is the name. By chanting the name of Bhagavan, the name of the Rupa, the form of Bhagavan, the pastimes of Bhagavan, the associates of Bhagavan, the aurora of Bhagavan, manifest by the effect of the mantra, by the effect of Harinam. Therefore, Sahaja Bhavi, they give up the chanting of the Nama for their smile. That is not a process given by a single person. Therefore, we should chant strongly on the chant loudly. By chanting loudly, first the name appears in the tongue, then he appears in the heart. So, Satyabhat Muni, with great determination, he is chanting his mantra and finally, gradually, the form of Bhagavan awoke in the heart. One time I asked Sri Gurudev, when you're chanting mantra, pastimes are not appearing in my heart. No forms from nothing. Then Gurudev said, but the yoga. Manasi, Samit, Pramati. Bhakti Yoga, Manasi, Samit, Pramati, Amanda, Pasha, Pusham, Purnam, Vyas, and Pasha. The Buddha said, what do you think? Without Bhakti Yoga, you can see the Supreme Lord. Therefore, the answer is Bhakti Yoga, Manasi. His mind will be absorbed in Bhakti. Then in Bhakti Samadhi, we have Darshan of what? Param Purusha Krishna and his Shakti Shimadhi. We have to be determined. Patience should be there at chanting mantra. Even if I do not achieve perfection this life, I must achieve next life or next life. But one life I must achieve. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had one associate, one Buddha. So when Mahaprabhu manifested his Buddha being Vishnu, the 20th Astapada Prakash, then Mahaprabhu giving so many benedictions to the devotees according to their desire. Some praying, oh, Mahaprabhu, please bless me with Nishya and Peter Gurudev. Some of them, oh, Mahaprabhu, please bless me, I can become free from analysis. Everyone according to their qualification of asking for benedictions. One time, I remember Sri Gurudev was a grandfather, and all the Bhagavad pandas came and they were singing. And Gurudev said, whatever you want, I'll give you what you want. And he said, well, Maharaj, give us 50 rupees. Said, how much you are unfortunate, I'm going to give you Radharani 7, and you are asking for it. But I'll give you Radharani 7, and you also get the 50 rupees in Boston. Everyone according to the list, you are asking for benedictions. Then, someone said, Guru, you are not giving any blessings to Buddha. Then, Mahaprabhu became angry. Hey, no, Buddha has no Nishtha. When he goes to the Gyanis, he glorifies Gyan. When he's with the Karmis, he glorifies Karma. And when he's with the Bhakti, the devotee says, I go, I go. Therefore, I don't want to see distress. And if anyone in this world rejects you, you can go somewhere else.
No.
But if God rejects you, where can you go? He's everywhere. And when they gave the boundaries to Mukunda, God would have rejected you. Mukunda was crying, can I see him in another world? And then the devotees asked, Mahaprabhu. Mukunda is asking, can he see you in a future birth? And Mahaprabhu was angry. I will see him after 1 million births. And they gave that magic bad news. Bad news, the Lord will see you after 1 million births. Mukunda began dancing. Hari Bol, Hari Bol. He has promised, I only have to wait 1 million births. And again, he has not rejected me completely. So when Mahaprabhu heard, he had this patience, this nishtha. And Mahaprabhu called him. So chanting mantra, I have to deal with it right now. Perfection is not coming again and again to practice. And Gita Krishna says, on the asking, one has to practice that. So, by chanting mantra and the guidance of Guru, then Prachodaya, Lassa Kundaram is all good at Rajamantra. Therefore, may all the incarnations have so much beauty, but the beauty of Sri Krishna that is unsurpassed. That beauty attracts all jivas. It attracts even other incarnations. Such is the beauty of Sri Krishna. It causes astonishment to everyone. Jiva Diyosi. For this figure, women and man, it attracts even living entities like trees, grass, cows. We hear in Vedic, Danyasmo, the Mandeo, the Mahindra. And Sri Krishna showed his beauty, even deers, cows. Even stones like Virat, Ramana, clouds are all attracted by his beauty. There was a beauty manifested by Krishna, especially where Lata Kundaram or Guru Bhajamana in Gokul, that is more than any other incarnation. What to speak of one time when Sri Ramchandra, on the order of his father, went to the Dandakaranya forest, and in Dandakaranya, some savage were doing bhajan. By Gopal Mantra. So when they saw Lord Ram, they desired to work in their heart. But we would also like to serve a bit like Sita Devi, like why? Prayers. Then Ram, he smiled, he could understand their desire, not possible. Because Ram, Chandra is Raja, he is bound, of course, he is independent also, but in his real life, showing his. Bound by the rules of Vedanta, according to these pastimes. Of course, Ram can also cross all Vedas if he wishes. But in this pastime, he is showing that there are only two vowing one part. But Ram could understand the desire. He said, I cannot fulfill your desire in this form. But when I come in form, you got all through your desire. Then the Sabbath of Dhanaraka, I mean, pray, please show us that form you will come in form you got. And Ram said, because on this Krishna is my father. Only he is Svatsiddhatma, completely self-manifest. Even our incarnations depend upon my father, avatar is Krishna, for their father. Therefore, four things special in Sri Krishna that are not present in any other incarnation, that is his Venerably, his Venerably, his Brahmably, and his Rupa. Ram could not manifest the form of Sri Krishna. Sri Krishna can manifest the form of any form, his Sarva-rupa. In one sense, Sri Krishna has become all forms. Krishna can become, his Rupas have manifested in the devas like Ganesh and Shankar. Krishna can manifest himself as those forms, but they cannot manifest themselves as Sri Krishna. Therefore, Ram carved the deity of Sri Krishna. That deity is Kicho of Gopina. Therefore, Krishna's beauty is such that attracts everyone, even other incarnations. We hear even Lakshmi and Sita. All were attracted by the beauty of Sri Krishna. See, Krishna's beauty is such, it even astonishes itself. We hear one time Sri Krishna, he saw himself in the mirror. Such was the beauty of his own form. Krishna's body, unconscious. And that topmost beauty is manifested where? In Vrajamanda. Even though Krishna manifests these pastimes also in Mathura, example, Swami described in Brihad Bhagavatamrita, when Nalapinda Leela occurred, when Krishna heard the glories of the gopis from Nanda Buddha, he fell unconscious. And they placed him on the back of Garuda and took him to Nalapinda that was manufactured by Lord Brahma. That time, Balaram also took off his Chandra Vesh, put on his Gopa Vesh, Chandra. He took off the armor of Sri Krishna, put peacock feather, flute, Chandra. And then all the demigods of Satyabhama, Rukmini, all watching. What is Krishna's beauty in Vrajana? Then Balaram, hey, Kanaya, wake up! The cows are there, without you, they will not go for Gochan. Come on, come on. Then Sri Krishna woke up and he saw Radha and their devotees and Yashoda Devi. Everything just like Vrindavan. Then Krishna saw, oh, I'm from Vrindavan. They are really the Buddha, Nanda Nandan, Yashoda Nandan, Sri Krishna Nandan. Then he saw Mother Yashoda, that devotee, Mother Yashoda had some father in her hand. Then Krishna said, oh, such a dream I had, Mother. I dreamt I became a king, I went to Dwarka, married 16,100 men queens. Many of them. I had so many children, amazing dream. Then Balaram said, oh, Mother Yashoda, you are sleeping so late, Mother Yashoda thinking you are sick. Therefore she cannot speak anything. He was mortal. Then Krishna took the Balaram half, he is eating and half eating for Balaram. Then he went for Gosha. God rest in so beautiful form at that time. Even Satyabhama Rukmini had never seen that form, that beautiful form of Krishna in Vrindavan. They became mad, they ran to embrace him. Then some of the wives of Krishna, like Kalini, they'd seen Kalini and Balaram's mother, Rukmini. They'd seen this form before, therefore they could control themselves. Therefore they were holding back Satyabhama Rukmini. But Parmavati, the conscious mother, and maybe she was 150. She became full of lust and began running to embrace Krishna. Such as the attraction of Krishna where? In Gokul. Therefore, Bhagavan has many forms, but that top most beauty is manifested where? Of course, when he is with Sri Radhika, how did he manifest the top most beauty? We have not reached that. Therefore, Krishna's baby form in Gokul, how much is it attractive? There was such a mood now, some desire is awakening his heart to form this Buddha Vatsalyas. We're hearing Maharaj describing from Dasgarasa begins, but now it's maturing to Vatsalyas because so much feelings of Mamasa is there. Tata Bhavadi Madhura, Nasrita, Nira, Mekshade, Nasrasa, 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 describes when greed is there to serve Krishna, which is not dependent on logic and not dependent on shastra, that is the awakening of Radhavoy Bhakti Bhavu. No, that is the symptom of Radhavoy Bhakti. So now, Sadhuramani has a great desire, not just meditating on Iswara or Paramatma, but now he wants to achieve see Krishna where? In Gokul, under the guidance of Sri Mahaprabhu. Therefore, Rasa Kundalam Gokul Rajamana. Those earrings are swinging, as if kissing the cheeks of Sri Krishna. And why those earrings are swinging? Because Sri Krishna is running. He is running very fast, but Mahaprabhu is running even more fast behind him. And he is running in those earrings and kissing his cheeks. Therefore, Sri Krishna, he does not need any ornaments to beautify himself. Sri Krishna does not need any ornaments to increase his beauty, but by those ornaments being placed on the body of Sri Krishna, then those ornaments achieve beauty and perfection. When the gopis dress, Mani servants are meeting Krishna as a young boy. They put in the morning, the servants and some like dusty gopis, they wash Krishna and comb his hair. Oh, it's okay, look, we have made your dark boy beautiful by casual and ornaments. Then Mother Yashoda becomes angry. Well, these things can make my daughter beautiful now. These things make achieved beauty and perfection. And the gopis are seeing those earrings, and she's seeing Krishna, how much fortune those earrings are. Those earrings are said by Maka, Kara, and Dhammas. Cupid himself, and well, maybe Krishna, when he's running away from his mother and mother's son, is chasing him. Mother's son is running faster than Krishna, otherwise he cannot catch him. Therefore, Lasa Kundara Guru, his son is running behind him, and his earrings are swinging. His form is very much attractive to Krishna's baby form. Satyagraha Muni is now entering the pastimes of Vrindavan. As we continue hearing this Gandharas, we will hear what he realizes as a result of chanting his mantra. He realizes all about you. After he realizes all this, Bhagavad-gita, and after some desires there to enter under the guidance of Srimad Radhakrishna, he surely does not reach a voice of God. Everyone will not become disappointed. This double rasping is like the whole ocean has been put in one glass. All Krishna leaders put their life. See Satyagraha Muni, because we should not forget the Easter day of this month is Sri Dhamma. Which Dhamma? According to Dhamma, was it bound by Mahasoda? But after we will hear that Dhamma was bound by the friends of Sri Dhamma. There was Sri Dhamma asking him. So after breakfast, we are going to. After breakfast, we'll go to this empty tower that's behind. Then to Seraphonish, Sri Radha Gaudiya Temple, then Sri Kamba. And all the way home, we go to Sri Charumamba.
After this, we can go to my class, mobile, many times, because monkey, the three persons, the three brothers, just still in the high class, fast, getting high class.
Thank you very much for coming.